we are doing this Nadi Shodhana Pranayama. You are inhaling through left and exhaling through the right. Inhaling through the right, exhaling through the left. We are giving equal opportunity for both nostrils. Though we have nasal opening is only one here, we have two partitions. These two partitions, why these two partitions? It has its own significance. When you are inhaling through the left nostril, you are energizing the right brain. When you are inhaling through the right, you are energizing the left brain. We have, every one of us, we have two personalities. One is a heart-centered personality, one is a head-centered personality. Yesterday in the discussion, somebody in the Bhagavad Gita class asked about the mind. And I talked about the mind. Mind has components, different sections, like five categories: mana, buddhi, ahankara, chitta, chetana. Five categories: mana, buddhi, ahankara, chitta, chetana, intellect and mind. Intellect, right nostril, breathing through the right nostril, it is connected to our intellectual center. Breathing through the left nostril, it is connected to our emotional center. And in scriptures, they talk about mind and intellect as wife and husband. Mind is a wife and intellect is a husband. Both for harmonious existence, harmonious home, harmonious body, we need this intellect and mind should coexist in harmony. Intellect and mind should coexist in harmony. Then husband and wife should coexist. Then this house will remain at peace. You need, it's a well-developed emotional center, well-developed head center, well-developed heart center, well-developed head center. If only the husband is dominating, only intelligence is dominating, I have no belief in anything. Everything I question. I don't believe. I want to argue. And there is no peace. Samshayatma vinashyati. Bhagavad Gita Shri Krishna talks about one who doesn't believe in anything. For that person there is no progress. At certain time, certain things we have to accept. When they are beyond our understanding, we have to accept. Scriptures, when we are reading, if only the intelligence is very alert, I am reading text and I see only intelligence is alert and I will be questioning the author, questioning the history and questioning that message. It's a cock and bull story. It is no substance. I don't trust anything, no scriptures, no practice, so that it will bring down my own ruin. In the heart center, I should have emotional. When I understand, when I go to a teacher, when I attending the yoga class, I should have a faith in the teacher. With humility, I should approach. When you come to the class, you should bow down to the teacher. That culture, it is there in many Asian countries also. Asian countries, when they come to the class, they first bow down. I bow down to the Lord in you. And they bow down. And we acquired couple of degrees. We made some couple of bucks. Now my intelligence has taken over. Why I should bow down? I pay the fees and I paid whatever I have to do. I paid. Why I should bow down? For that person, there is no progress. Emotional heart should be open. You should have a humility. When you are reading the scriptures with humility and you are praying to the Lord, may you open up the inner meaning. I don't understand. I am illiterate. Though I can read some sentences, I don't understand. I am illiterate. Please illumine my consciousness. With humility, I should read. Heart center should open up. When the heart is there and then it's I start getting deeper into the sadhana. But if only the heart is open, I believe everything, whatever people say, whether right interpretation, left, wrong interpretation, I don't care. I believe everything. So, I will be misguided. I need well-developed heart and head. Then only I can make progress. Yoga means balance. Balance of right brain and left brain. Balance of intelligence and emotion. Balance of your breathing through the left nostril, Ida. And breathing through the right is Pingala. Ida and Pingala should coexist in harmony. My airways should be clear. Both left and right should be clear. So that there is a harmony within the house. That is the theory behind doing the anuloma viloma. Again, we'll close your right nostril. Complete exhale through the left. Chin, back, neck in one line. Inhale through left. Close your left nostril. Exhale through the right. Inhale through right. Close your right nostril. Exhale through left. Inhale through left. Exhale through right. Inhale through right. Exhale through left. Two more rounds. Inhale through left. Deep inhale, long inhale. Your stomach expands, chest expands. Exhale, complete exhale through the left. Chest goes in, stomach goes in. Inhale through right. Exhale through left. Complete exhale. And down. To turn off. Long inhale and longer exhale.